You know, I was allowed to have the final cut that I normally have when I'm directing. And he said, so I know I don't have any control over this, but the one thing that I would just suggest and is that looking at this time frame of just the touring years, and when I look at some of the pictures, John and I were really friends. We really loved each other. There's a lot that happened afterwards that scarred us both, and I still feel it today. But I recognize that when you're talking about this time period, that was a difference, and it's sort of been forgotten, even by me a little bit. Mm-hmm. And I think this is a chance. So I thought that was just an interesting insight. I think that, you know, we've done so many projects about, you know, scripted projects, and often the people were still alive. Mm-hmm. And I think that at the end of the day, that, you know, your obligation is to the story and the audience, sure, but you do know you're going to have to look this individual in the eye at some point. Right. And if you've synthesized, if you've made a kind of a shortcut in any way, you have to be able to really explain that you made it with integrity to support the narrative and some other truth. Mm-hmm. And so I think whether it's scripted or you know, or whether it's a straight documentary, you always want to be able to look yourself in the mirror, and you certainly want to be able to look your subject in the mirror or their survivors,
right.
And you know, and feel that you got at the truth, mm-hmm. but you still had to make something that was compelling, entertaining, and of course, it's editorial. I mean, I don't care if it's a piece of journalism or a scripted piece or a documentary. Of course, it's an opinion. It's a point of view. It's an expression. You know, who knows what the truth, you know,
right.
is? It's
your truth,
it's your sense of it.
Mm-hmm.